I'll give you the. I'll give you the. So I am not Muslim.
I know.
But yeah, but the story he is giving cannot be approved from the Islamic tradition. So Islamic tradition tells us, at the time of Muhammad, we didn't have the written copy of the Quran. We didn't have the written copy. So they compiled the Quran in the time of Abu Bakr. Correct me if I am.
At one time in day, there was a person like me that got a pen
yeah.
and put it on a paper and put it together.
Yeah.
So I want to know who that yeah. guy was.
So there was a Quran.
Which was very important.
Yeah, he wants to know who wrote it.
He's like me.
Are you a Christian, sir?
I was born a Christian.
So who wrote the Bible?
I'll answer that question. No, which part of the Bible?
Who wrote the Bible? Yeah. A man like me that likes women.
40 different people in 40 different locations.
I'm not about both.
Yeah, okay.
So let me just clarify a couple of things. According to Islamic tradition, we didn't have the Quran at the time of Muhammad. In 632 to 634, Abu Bakr anointed Zayd bin Thabit to write down the Quran. But by that time, lots of people who memorized the Quran, they died. Okay, so they lost lots of part of the Quran. There was a problem with the Quran has been written down by Zayd bin Thabit. In 650s, under the Uthman, they made brand new Quran with editing a couple of extra verses. Today, the Quran we have has nothing to do with the Quran which has been written down approximately 20 years after Muhammad, because we don't have that Quran. So the current Quran I'm holding and this brother is holding has been officialized in 1924 in Cairo. Is that correct, sir?
Okay, no answer.
Yeah.
Okay, first of all, I don't want to talk about this topic because I'm not a scholar of the Quran, etc. But what I'm trying to say is, from the history, when the time of the Prophet Muhammad was killed, the year he died, okay, he recited the whole Quran twice in Ramadan. Like, even in Ramadan today, you go to any mosque and a Chinese Hatun. Listen, let me finish. Hatun, go to the mosque around the UK, in Ramadan. When the Imam recites the Quran, a little kid will correct the Imam who makes a mistake. So the Quran was preserved through memorization. That's the primary source of.
I'm going to respond to your challenge.
Let me just talk,
Okay.
Compiling the Quran, like Hatun said, was happening even in the time of the Muhammad was born. That happened even in his time. But the primary source of preservation is memorization. That's the primary source. And this, she mentioned this Quran, okay? No Muslim will say this is the Quran verbatim. Rather, we say this is a mere translation of the Quran, okay? The Quran is in Arabic. So what we challenge Hatun and any of our followers to do is to bring me two Qurans in Arabic, two Qurans in Arabic that are different and contradict each other. You understand? And that have sources that are contradiction. And read the verses. Yep. Read the verses in Arabic.
I'm going to respond to that.
If you don't know Arabic,
I'm going to respond to that.
Inshallah.
Yeah. So let me.
But I don't want to talk about this. Next week, inshallah, we'll do that.
No. I think let's first finish this one because I don't know this gentleman. What's your name?
Dean.
I don't know you. Have you been to Speaker's Corner before? No. So it is his first time at Speaker's Corner. I believe he deserves proper conversation on that. And I am here every week. We can discuss the sin and salvation as it comes. So, brother said, I'm Christian. I don't believe Quran is the word of God. Because reason for that is, as a Christian, my scripture teaches, we don't need any book or any other prophet after Messiah. Whatever is in the Bible, that needed to be in the Bible and it's closed. We don't need another book. Yet, when you look at the Quran, you see Quran contradicts the Bible. So you examine it and then see what it teaches. As I don't believe in the Quran, yet I try to study Quran to engage with Muslims. So brother said here that Quran has been memorized. That's what makes it like reliable or preserved.
Yeah,
but here's the problem. Here's the problem. Memorization of the Quran, this gentleman believes it was faithfully and truthfully has been memorized. When you look at the earliest writings of the Islam, you see even Muhammad, who is the last prophet and best example for Muslim world, did not remember the whole Quran. He needed help from other people to remind him. So memorization of Muhammad wasn't good. Yet, people who memorized the Quran, when we look at the earliest Islamic sources, Sahih Bukhari tells us the reason they wrote the Quran down, because people who memorized the Quran, they died in the battle, therefore they lost big chunk of the Quran. Let's put it together. So the Quran we have, if when you go according to tradition, has already been lost by big chunks of it. For example, even if the memorization was very good, still there are certain Quranic verses which has been practiced in some Muslim countries, but it's not in the Quran. For example, stoning adulteries was part of the revelation, but couldn't make it to the Quran. Aishah, favorite wife of Muhammad, tells us God came and ate the Quranic verses. So current Quran we have has actually nothing to do with Muhammad. Verses. Quran is not the only revelation to the Muhammad, correct me if I'm wrong, because there are the Quranic passages within the Quran. It was Umar, who never met Allah, who never had any revelation. Umar stepped in and then allowed Muhammad to receive revelation from Allah, what Umar was desired for. There are the Quranic verses in the Quran, has nothing to do with Muhammad, has nothing to do with Allah, but they end up in the Quran because of Umar. So current Quran we are reading, as I said, has been canonized in 1924. What I'm saying, Islamic tradition. This is what Islamic tradition says.
You know who actually put the book together? Does anybody know the answer to that question?
I don't know. I can tell you, this Quran, which has been officialized, I think the Arabic version has been, it has been officialized, a committee in Cairo. It has nothing to do with Muhammad, and it officialized in 1924. And brother challenged me to go any mosque and then bring Muslims who are disagreeing with what the Quran itself says, or if Imam is making mistake, then someone corrects. But at the time of Muhammad, Muhammad made lots of mistakes as he recited the Quran. Because we look at the Islamic tradition, two people are fighting because
Muhammad, they never make any mistake. And tell me, when is this, the Hyde-park Bukhari?
Let me finish.
Ask any Muslim, tell him when.
Let me finish.
Eat the Quran and ask any Muslim, he say,
let me finish.
Never believe that.
Let me finish. It's up to Muslims to believe it or not. I'm telling you what the Islamic tradition tells us. So people at the time of Muhammad, they recited one of the surah in the Quran very differently. The way they recited it was very different.
You know, like, where do you get your?
So you,
I mean, basically, what you're trying to say is that.
What is my?
Let me say something.
Yeah, you were saying Muhammad didn't know, but where you get your credential is?
Yeah. So Hatun, what this is. Very good point you mentioned, right? Let me just emphasize on this point, yeah? When we have debates and discussions, we need to have academic background. Like, for example, yeah, many Christians come up to me and say, your Bible is proof that Jesus is the Son of God, for example, something like that. Something ridiculous like that. Like, you know, like, the Quran, every verse in the Quran has a reason why it's revealed, a place when it's revealed, and the cause of revelation, you know, and has explanation behind the verse, yeah? That the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his companions explained the verse. So we can't just give our own interpretation to the verses of the Quran. Likewise, Islam is fixed. We have a sort of fiqh in Islam. We have fiqh in Islam to determine what are the sources. Like, for example, we have an asul in Islam called maslaha, which is benefit. That is established, you know, in Islam. We have many different asuls, you know. and many different things that are defined, like Salah is defined, you know, Jihad is defined, what the Khilafah system is defined in Islam. You can't just come as a Christian and say, this is what it is. So what is your credentials, number one, and number two? Yeah, it's very important.
It's the same as what I'm saying about who wrote the book. Because say a man like me wrote it with my own agenda, my own, then I could put a few things in. And then like you...
I agree.
You believe it's a faith. The same as this lady, it's a belief, it's a faith. But there's no fact, and the book is 2,000 years old. It's 2,000 years of age, so no one knew these people. It ain't like I can speak to you and say, you know what, don't believe a word he's saying. Or I could say, I'm telling you, everything this guy's saying is the truth.
Yeah. You know what, I'm not most knowledgeable to like go into details in this subject. Yeah, yeah. But if you just go on YouTube and type in seashells rebuttal, okay, and
YouTube is the worst example you can give.
It's a good,
because I could go on YouTube.
Sir, can I let me?
No, it's a good rebuttal to what she's saying, isn't it?
But not really. Let me tell you. I told you because it is first time this gentleman is at speaker's corner.
I'm gonna pray.
Okay,
talk
come back
and then come back inshallah.
But I love you to listen what I'm saying, because I'm talking about Islam, while not Muslim is representative, it's just not true, not right.
Well, your source has to be from Muslim source.
Yeah, I'm gonna give you the Muslim sources.
Muslim source, yeah. That has been changed, etc. Yeah.
I'm gonna
That's what your point.
Yeah.
Right, inshallah, we'll come back inshallah. No problem, yeah? Remember what you said.
Okay. Right. Do you mind waiting for 5 minutes until he comes back?
Yeah, don't put me on camera. Though.
Okay. So, where do I get my sources is, it is interesting because...
You've got to remember now, it's over 1,500 years ago.
So, let me just respond. So, it is actually a heartbreaking fact for Islam that they do have nothing about Muhammad's by Muslim, so like biography of Muhammad, we don't have anything from 7th century. Earliest biography of Muhammad we have is over 200 years after his death.
So he's a myth, basically by then.
You can put however you want, but earliest biography of Muhammad are too late and written by someone who never met with Muhammad. So the other thing is when we look at Islamic sources, so you've got the biography of Muhammad. Also, you've got the customs of Muhammad, which is identified as the Hadith. So you've got six big Hadith collections, which tells you customs of Muhammad. What he did, what he said, when he smiled, what is application of that, when he was silent. And earliest Hadith collection we have, one of them is Sahih Bukhari. It is dated 250 years after death of Muhammad, and it is written by someone who never met with Muhammad. So when you ask the sources, Sahib Imam Bukhari never met, and he never met Muhammad either as well. So that's not the biography of Muhammad. For that, so when you look at the earliest, it's not the biography. That's not the customs of Muhammad. Yeah, I'm gonna give it to you. Just wait. So it is heartbreaking fact that Islam doesn't have their early sources are 200 years after death of Muhammad versus they've got not any manuscript evidence which they can support that. So, like, Mutawata, what is the earliest manuscripts?
Mutamalik, yeah?
Yeah, what is the earliest manuscripts?
Well, it's first century, what? Within the 100 years.
You don't have any earliest manuscripts for that?
No, we don't have early manuscripts.
So, you don't have earliest manuscripts?
Okay, can you show me the earliest manuscripts of the Bible?
Sure, P52. Bible.
That's complete.
That's just close, 200 BC.
I'm very sorry, yeah? I have to make an announcement that I cannot come back. I have to be in Edmonton for 7:30, and it's Ramadan. I have to break my fast. So next week we continue the discussion, but not on this topic of Quran. We continue it on the salvation in Christianity and Islam.
Salvation.
And if you want to talk about this, I'm available in Stratford every Saturday.
Okay.
So come inshallah if you want to discuss it as well.
Remember, I am going to bring you...
Yeah, bring the book inshallah.
I'm going to bring you the book, which you will borrow. Yeah. Borrow.
Yes, borrow.
And then do your homework. I love you to do your homework,
right,
and then come back. And other thing is,
You too.
I can support what I say regarding the bad memory of Muhammad, and I would love you to hear my sources and then respond to them. Maybe that can be next week.
Also, academically speaking, okay, you have to get the sharh. Even though in Islam we have sharh for hadith, yeah, explanation for the hadith. So the Sahaba or they will have mufassirin, and the scholars of hadith will give explanations to the hadith. Like Ibn Hajar gives explanation to Bukhari, you know, he gives explanation to what Bukhari, the hadith in Bukhari, etc. So if you want to be extensive in your research and your, you know, the way you're coming across, give it from the scholarly backing. Have scholarly backing behind you, inshallah. That's all.
But remember,
yes, obviously, yes,
one of the things essential for you to remember, yes, might be, yes, Quran makes a claim. It is well detailed, well explained.
Yes.
Therefore, you should not even need of hadith or even the commentaries for the hadith. That's a different topic, but we will discuss Sinan salvation next week. And also I would love you to hear my sources.
Jesus was
very bad Muslim. Jesus was a bad Muslim. See you next week, sir. No, just a moment. Just a moment.
Was he righteous? Jesus.
Just a moment. Brother, hold on. You didn't want to continue the conversation that you wanted to go. Now you are asking me question. If I tell you Jesus is righteous, I'm confirming the Quranic information, and also I'm confirming the biblical information. It is only God who is right.
Okay.
So, and it is only that right person makes you right with God himself.
Okay.
So therefore, please don't say Jesus was a Muslim, because you are insulting Islam and you are insulting Jesus.
Yeah, but what is a Muslim?
Muslim is the, according to 2018 definition, is the, you've got your beliefs and then you've got your practices. Okay, put the beliefs together, put the practices together, those five pillars, six beliefs, all those kind of things. Jesus never prayed as Muslim prays. Jesus never went to Hajj and then went to kiss a black stone. Let me finish.
Jesus prayed like Muslims pray.
Muslims, do you ever, when you pray, call God Father?
Call God Father?
No, because Quran doesn't give you right. Quran doesn't give you right to go call God Father. Okay. Surah 5, verse 18.
We're talking about how Jesus.
Let me just finish. Yeah. As Jesus prayed, what did Jesus call God? Father. And every Christian.
Jesus spoke English?
Every Christian knows. Every Christian and even the Muslims know our famous prayer.
I don't know why I carried this on.
Starts with the Father, confirms Jesus cannot be Muslim. If I was a Muslim, he was a bad Muslim.
See you next week.
I make dua that inshallah Hatun.
See you next week, sir. I am Christian.
Always.
See you next week.
Always run away.